So in this video, I'm going to talk a little bit about the detailed mechanics of the French grip stroke. So this is the stroke you're going to use when you're playing the flying fingers type blast beat, and it's a finger-based stroke. There's not much wrist action in it. So the first thing you'll notice, thumb on top. So it's not to the side because that would be a German grip, but on top is the French grip. Then these back fingers become very important. You have your fulcrum here, two fingers. These other three fingers, you want to contact the stick right about at the first knuckle. If you get too far in to the second knuckle, it's very hard to generate power. If you're all the way out at the tip, you're probably just going to slide right off the stick. So you want to have that one knuckle's worth of security, and that keeps it about the right distance from your hand as well. So if I play a few strokes like that, see, my hand doesn't move much, it's just my fingers going back and forth. And I'll do a slow-mo of that. Here's the bird's eye view. You can see my thumb is directly down the stick. And when I play, the stick stays very close to my hand. I can even go down to a different view. If the stick gets out here away from your hand, it's very difficult to control. If it's hitting your hand, it's not going to work. But if it's very close to and just sliding past on the stroke, that's going to be the best control. So a great way to work on the French grip stroke is to just play one stroke at a time. Try to start with the stick vertical or nearly vertical, play a note, and have the stick come all the way back to vertical. If you find yourself playing the stroke and then having to lift the stick back to vertical, you've done too much work. It shouldn't be that hard. You should play the stroke, and the stick should almost want to roll backwards out of your hand, and you have to stop it. If you're having to lift it, that means that you're not getting enough rebound. Another thing you can do to work on this is go one finger at a time. So you can play strokes with just your middle finger doing the pushing, just your ring finger doing the pushing, and even just your pinky doing the pushing. And if you get competent at doing all the fingers individually, then eventually when you put them back together, it'll seem really easy to get a fine stroke out of all three fingers pushing together.